Welcome back, and thanks for joining me for Miss H's home learning. Today's lesson is going to be for everyone. So this can be for teachers, it can be for students, it can be for parents. So after our first week of remote learning, there has been a lot of talk about the site's not loading, or the feed going in and out, or the Google Meet cutting, or calls being dropped, and kids then calling the school saying, "Hey, Miss H, I'm gonna come return my Chromebook. You need to give me a new one." Well, guys, I hate to break it to you, but it's not the device. That is myth number one. It's not the device. Unfortunately, it is the Wi-Fi. We're going to talk about some possible solutions on what we can do to try to make sure that we can stay in our Google Meet and make sure we can stay connected so that we can continue our education while we are in this remote setting. So, we have seven possible solutions in order to make sure we can stay connected and maintain our connection with our classes. Our first one is close all the browsers, all the web pages, all the apps, all those things on your computer. So you want to make sure that at the bottom of your screen here that you don't have a whole bunch of different apps open, that you don't have a game playing in the background, that you have your music video playing, you're listening to something on the side, that we have a bunch of different tabs open like I do here. That is just not what you want happening, because then you are splitting the attention of the internet basically, and it's trying to keep all these different things, and you're splitting all the bandwidth to try to keep all these different things up and open. So, when you are in class, the only thing you want to have open is that Google Meet, so all of the attention and all the bandwidth is going to that one meet. All right, so that is solution number one. Number two, it's called a power cycle. So, basically, all that is you're going to go to your modem and your router, and you're going to turn them off. Completely shut them down for 10 seconds, so count to 10, and then you're going to turn them back on again. So sometimes that is as simple as it takes. They just need a reset, and that is just going to help kind of reset the IP address, and that will help with your connectivity. Number three is actually very simple. It's going to be the router placement. Often we don't realize it, but we're taking the router of your internet, and people will put them because they don't like what they look like, or they want them out of the way, and they will put them in a cupboard or down low or in a corner or behind a wall. So they'll have them in one room and then you are in your other room and there's things that are in the way. So maybe there's concrete in between you and your router, or they're down low and you're up high. You really want to make sure your router is above you, and you want to make sure that there's nothing in between you and that router. So you want to have a clear line between you and your router. Number four, jump start your Wi-Fi. So when your car battery goes dead, you know how you have to put the black and red cable on, you kind of jump start it to kind of kick it going. Wi-Fi, actually, you can kind of do that too. So I'm going to give you a trick to do that. So you're going to go to a browser, and all you're going to do is you're going to go to Google, and you're going to type in Google speed test. And what's going to pop up is this right here, and you're just going to run a speed test. And really, what that's doing is it's testing your download and your upload speed, but it also kind of gives it a jump start. And sometimes that's all it takes, is it really just needs a little kick in the butt, and it's going to just give it a little oomph, and it's going to open the floodgates and allow you to get a little bit more juice in your internet and help you get going on the Wi-Fi. So maybe right before your Google Meet, you're going to go ahead and give yourself a little speed test. Another thing that you might want to do, check your modem or your router. Make sure that they're still up to date. So check with Comcast, see if you have the most up-to-date one and that they're still compatible with high-speed internet and that they don't need to be swapped out for a better addition, to make sure that you have the right one to withstand high-speed internet and all the users that are in your household. Because sometimes if you have multiple users that are on and trying to stream at the same time, we just need to make sure that you have the modem and the router that can accommodate all of that. Okay? And then another one that we might have to actually have you guys do is in your Google Meets. This is going to be something that is going to be great. So you're going to go into your Google Meet, And you're actually going to change the setting of your Google Meet from high definition to standard definition. And so high definition is going to take a lot more bandwidth, a lot more Wi-Fi than standard definition. And so what you're going to do is you're going to change the setting. So down here in your three little dots, you're going to go to settings, and you're going to have in here all your different options. So you're going to click on video, and notice you have high definition, and your and it says maximum. You're going to actually change that to standard definition, and then change this to standard definition. So notice it lowers the number. So it did make it a little bit bigger and a little bit grainier, but it's going to take less power and less bandwidth to run that speed, and you're going to have less interruption then. This is going to be a better speed. So you're not going to have the interruption, and you're not going to get a drop call as much. And so I think this will be a better option for you if you're having issues with your internet when you're in your Google Meets. All right? So these are some really great tips. Now, the last and final one, if you're still really having issues, then you're going to have to call Comcast and see what's going on. But in the interim, you can use your cell phone depending on your carrier and depending on your data plan. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take your cell phone, all right, and you're going to go into your settings. So you're going to find your settings on your phone, okay? And in your settings, you're going to find something called personal hotspot right in here. And you're going to say, you're going to turn it on. Okay? Once that is on, then you're going to go up into here where your Wi-Fi is, and then you're going to find your phone. So now notice Katie's phone pops up, and you're going to click that. And now my computer, see how it now linked? So now my computer and my phone are linked. And now I'm going to be using my phone for Wi-Fi rather than my actual Wi-Fi. And I'll have the exact same results, and I can use the data on my phone and the Wi-Fi on my phone, and I'll be able to get into my Google Meets. So those are some tricks and tips in order to make sure that we can still participate and get onto our Google Meets and not have those freeze-ups or that lagging or that slow internet in order to participate, have a smooth transition into our remote learning. I hope that helped. If you have any questions or have any comments, feel free to leave them below. I hope this helped. As always, share with a friend, subscribe, like, and we'll see you next time. Take care.